ladies and gentlemen, and especially welcome to our special guest of honor, Ms. Penny Guiterrez. And I'll have to get my list out for the sons. Okay, first is Andrew, Jeremiah, you're JD, right? Okay, what do you go by, Jeremiah or JD?
Jeremiah.
Okay, this is Jeremiah, and we got Gabriel. Mrs. Foss is Patty's mom. In the back we have the Valteras. David, the deceased sergeant's mom, and stepfather, the Valteras. This is a special honor for us to, you know, and kind of sad too that we have to meet under such circumstances. But we're, you know, grateful to David for his sacrifice. We'd like to say thank you, and for that, we will be indebted forever. Just something that happens as part of real life, and unfortunately, some bad things happen, we're glad that you were able to make it here. It's a pleasure. Well, I'm getting ready to retire, and I was hoping that it was done before I retired. It is happening that way, so it's good. And I'd like to introduce you to our team leadership. Lieutenant Fisher, our watch commander, our team sergeant, Sergeant Brackett, one of our supervisors, Sergeant Chabani, and we have another one that's kind of busy, Sergeant Pennington, he is busy, and Sergeant No, they're not right here right now. And our technician in the video, Sean McNeely, Officer McNeely, and we're hoping that we can provide you with a video tape for the pre-training. Play, you know, your home, this ceremony. And now I'd like to introduce you to the men and women of D team. These are the people right here that are putting this on for you. So this is a good group of people just saying thank you. You know, like I said, it's been a while since we've been putting this together. We've done it before to two soldiers, two service members in your community, your watch. One of Jeffrey Ailes, you might know. You heard of him? Yes, okay. Janet, her mom, yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. And another one, Robert Alsor. His parents have moved to New Mexico. But we've done this before, and it's been a big success. So we're honored and excited at the same time to do it for you. With that in mind, we have a letter of condolence here. That's kind of like a sympathy card, and we'll have an announcer to read it for you. And these right here are five copies, one for each of your sons and mom. And it's really nice. Probably very important to take it to you. And at this time, we will have Officer Fernandez read the letter that we have for you.
Staff Sergeant David H. Guiterrez. The American people have been fighting for the freedom to establish the liberties as we know them today since the days of George Washington's Continental Army of 1775. The price of freedom has always been an expensive one. It has cost the lives of our fellow men and women who have set aside their personal lives and left their families in order to meet the call of duty for freedom. Today we're honoring a fellow American who has laid down his life at the altar of freedom in order to help guarantee the liberties we cherish every day. There have been many other Americans who have met this fate in the fight for freedom. Their sacrifice is what allows us to enjoy the American way of life. Staff Sergeant David H. Guiterrez left his wife and three children in Fort Lewis, Washington for his second deployment in the fight against terrorism. Like many other service members, he didn't dodge his duty and answer the call. Being a career soldier, he was confident in his ability to perform his duty as expected. The most difficult thing for him was the possibility of not returning to his family. Leaving behind his wife and children must have been the most difficult thing for him to accept. Surely there were other parents deploying that felt the same way. On December 25th, 2009, as we were enjoying the Christmas holiday, Staff Sergeant Guiterrez unit was in a dismounted patrol in Afghanistan. The patrol encountered enemy activity when an improvised explosive device detonated by the enemy seriously wounded him and soon after claimed his life. As fellow Americans, we hold Staff Sergeant Guiterrez and his family a debt that cannot be repaid. As a group of military veterans and patriotic people, we offer our deepest heartfelt condolences and would like to assure you the hurt you feel for your loss is also resting in our hearts. May our expression of sympathy find some consolidation in your heart and comfort the anguish of your bereavement. The members of Elmwood D Team Santa Clara County Department of Correction in Pitas, California, recognize Staff Sergeant Gutierrez's service to his country and appreciate the sacrifice made by his family.
Okay, Sergeant Guiterrez earned several awards, as you can see by the right here, and one of them is a Bronze Star. Got a miniature of Bronze Stars for each one of you, your wife and sons. I would suggest maybe wear on Memorial Day in his honor, and something you may want to share for, you know, as a safety even, if it's for you, or for each other. One for you, sir? One for you. Okay, I want to tell you something, okay? This is okay. These are Bronze Star Medal. Bronze Star Medal. They're very high award. The father got. They are not, they're for you, only for you. Your friends and your family and other people can just look at them. They don't touch them, okay? Very good. And you can wear them from Memorial Day to say, hey, man, you're a hero. Okay? And when you get it, you put it back in the black with help from mom, and then that'll be something for you to share the rest of your life, okay? Okay, I'm sure it's kind of like right now, not so much in your mind about it, but maybe you. But these two, like I say, oh, they'll get around to understand. But just keep in mind, nobody touches it. Just you. Okay? They're for you. Okay, what are they? Bronze Star Medal, right? Okay, definitely remember what it is. We'd like to present the family with this shadow box. This is it. The awards and that Staff Sergeant Gutierrez earned while he was in service. It's a place for a picture. I'm pretty sure that you'll find a place in your home for it. And now we're finally getting it to you. I'm sure that you see it. I think it's a nice, something hanging up that everybody will admire. Okay. This time we'll go into honors to David with the team. The team, attend, push! Present, push! Order. Order. Maybe see you. Patty, on your way out, I'm sure some of the gentlemen here can help you carry it. We have a plastic bag here, if you'd like to encase it, and the letters. I gave Ed two newspapers of the Army Times. One is a weekly casual piece, recorded and pictured on the Army Times. Another one is memorializing all the troops that were fallen soldiers and sailors and Marines and Air Force men. That, during the whole year is another one. A whole bunch of pictures. Ed has them for you over here. Right here, of the letters that I talked to you about, I'll give them to you right now. Okay. Patty, this concludes the ceremony. Let me back up a little bit. Sorry. Lieutenant Fisher, a watch commander. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to miss you.
It seems fitting that on a weekend when much of the world is focused on the life of someone who epitomized giving his life for others, that we honor your David, your Staff Sergeant. we would not be able to have the lives that we have today if it were not for men like him. And I just wanted to express our thanks to you for being willing to make that sacrifice of giving him to this country and allowing him to serve us and make sure that we can wake up every day with the freedoms that we have. And there's nothing that we can do that will bring him back to you, but all we can do is say that you have our deepest sympathy and our greatest appreciation for the service that he gave and the sacrifice. And we just hope this is just a little token of what we can do to help you in this time of loss. And just know that he will be remembered by us and by servicemen all over this country as someone who is a hero, and we appreciate heroes.
Now it's all up to you.
Actually,
thank you. Oh, thank you. Please.
Okay, so I don't have a speech, made up or anything, but I did want to thank all of you for taking the time to not only help me remember what a hero my husband was, but that you recognize it. So thank you for taking the time.
Can we have the fun lights turned off real quick? We have a...
I'm just trying to be a father, raise a daughter and a son. Be a lover to their mother, everything to everyone. Up and at 'em bright and early, I'm all business in my suit. Yeah, I'm dressed up for success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, my responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good under pressure, being all that I can be. I can't call in sick on Mondays when the weekend's been too strong. I just work straight through the holidays, sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost, I know the sacrifice. Oh, and I don't wanna die for you, but if dying's asking me, I'll bear that cross with honor, 'cause freedom don't come free. American soldier, an American, beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front line, so sleep in peace tonight.